writing these in slope-intercept form. Remember, slope-intercept form looks like this.
I did this with you today, but then you got angry at me.
Of course, this is going to look, it's not going to have an equals sign there, but we're going to kind of treat it like it is because we're using this to find the line. That's what the line is. The line is the set of points that makes both sides of the inequality the same, equal to each other. All right, so someone tell me, well, someone first help Kyler understand how to write up your shirt for you. And then someone else tell me how we get this into slope intercept form. Molly? This first green one.
The green one,
yeah.
Okay. You would subtract 2x from each side.
So now we're not going to switch the sign, right? Because we haven't multiplied or divided by a negative. It'll stay less than or equal to. Subtract 2x from both sides, we get negative 2x plus 5. Realize you might have written 5 minus 2x, but of course it's the same.
Oh, wait,
negative 2x plus 5, 5 minus 2x is the same. Negative 2x, well, 2x is still negative, 5 is still positive, it's all the same. So now we've succeeded, this is in slope-intercept form, we can graph it. Let's go ahead and do it for red. So we can just graph them both, one right after the other.
Subtract 2.
So we have y, and greater than or equal to negative 2x. Minus 2.
Sweet.
All right, so time to graph. Here's our graph. We'll start with green. And the graphing inequalities, we discussed at length yesterday, that there's a line part, we take blacked out half of the plane that we shade in with all the rest of the points that make the inequality not equal.
5.
We have y-intercept of 5. Slope of.
So would you go over 1, then down 2?
You would. All right, what kind of line are we going to use?
Oh.
Yes.
A solid line.
Solid line because we have the equal to. Which?
You're talking, please. We're going to have headphones for the rest of the day. You don't want that to happen.
Pair them up with
iPhone.
We were talking about C.
Stop talking about
C. We're in math class.
Headphones for the rest of the day.
Well, you should see this.
All right. So we're gonna graph a solid line. Make it green because
it was green.
It was. Go down.
Can you just shut your mouth?
2 over 1 and down 2. In that direction. Put some arrows on there. So this line is solid because we have the equal to part, which is just a reminder that this line is not really a line, it's millions and millions of points, each point having an x and y, and if I plug that x and y into the inequality, what happens? Both sides are equal.
I mean the same.
Equal to the same?
Yeah.
Either way, it means the same. Okay, now we're going to shade it in. Where are we going to shade? Aiden? If y is by itself, y needs to, because we have some confusion with this in second period. In order to use the less than means we're going to shade below, and the greater than means we're going to shade above, y has to be by itself. Okay? If it isn't, you might get lucky and shade the correct side, but you also may not.
-50/50.
So if y is by itself, and we have a less than, it means we're going to shade below. If you're not sure about that, how else could you figure out what side you're supposed to shade?
Right here.
Kyler?
Well, we didn't do the other side first, though.
Is it from the sign?
Well, yeah, do the other side.
The other side?
The y is greater than.
Yeah, the y is less than, so does that, like, fully mean that it would be down since it's less than?
Since y is by itself and it's less than and y is up and down kind of a thing, the lesser numbers, the smaller numbers.
But what about the y is greater than? Where's that one going to go?
Well, whatever this line looks like, we're going to shade above that one.
Yeah, I know, but negative 2.
Let's chill out on that for a second. We're not even done with the green one yet. How else can we tell which side we're supposed to shade?
Because of negative 2x.
Negative 2x absolutely does not tell me anything about which side I'm supposed to shade.
I don't know.
Aiden?
If you plug in 0, 0,
0, 0. As long as that 0, 0 is not part of the line, absolutely plug in 0, 0. Plug in 0 there, 0 there. We're gonna get 0 is less than 5. Is 0 less than 5?
Yeah.
0 is less than 5. So, 0, 0 is below the line, so we shade all the other points that are below the line. Okay, red. Red's next. Got a y-intercept of negative 2 and also a slope of negative 2, just like that other line. So what can we say about these two lines?
Parallel.
They are parallel. They have the same slope, meaning they're parallel. Alright, then we need to shade it.
Oh, question about the shading?
Question about the shading, Richard.
Does the line, is that like a wall that you can't shade over that?
Right.
What?
Yes.
Okay.
Remember, the line is a bunch of points. It's made up of a bunch of points. The points from that line make both sides equal.
I'm talking about the green line. Can, like, the red shade over?
Oh, no, it could. Yeah, the green line is something you could shade over. But here's the thing. If we think a little, like one step ahead of this, what we're looking for is not just to graph the green thing and graph the red thing. We're looking to find the solutions that these two inequalities share, the solutions that work in both of them. So since when I think about shading, I'm going to shade above or below?
Above.
Above. If I were to shade above, I would shade in all of this stuff here.
All this stuff up there, but it can't. Wait, the middle, you can't have the middle shaded in.
Why not?
Because it's going to be in between those two points. You can still shade it.
No, you can't.
Why can't you shade it?
Because it's 0, 0.
Because it's 0, 0?
Yeah, you can't do that.
Well, if we were to test 0, 0 in this one,
all I know
0,
is that
0, is 0 greater than or equal to negative 2?
Yeah.
It is. So it's just confirmation that since this point is above the line, we should be shading above the line. So if you just kind of forget about the green part for a second, if you can just kind of imagine it's not there, the red graph looks like this, a solid line like that, and shaded in red half like that. Okay? And right where it's Christmas is the overlapping solutions for both inequalities. That would be the solutions that work in both inequalities, the solutions to the system of inequalities. These are all of the points. One example, right? This is in the green shaded area. It's also in the red shaded area. It's 0, 0. We've already confirmed it works in both. Any point in here, like this one, right? What's that one? That was -4, 8. -4, 8. Okay. Let's look at it in the green one. 2 times -4 + 8. Let's see if this works. -8. Ooh, interesting. -8.
+8.
+8. The important part is, you know, is this relationship going to be true? Is 0 less than or equal to 5?
Yes.
What is less than or equal to 5? I just picked it out of the air. I picked this point right here.
-4.
Semi-randomly. Well, that's negative. Oh, that point's at -3. Well, let's just change the point that I picked to -2.
Well, 2 is still less than, so.
It would still work. Negative. If I plugged -3 in there, it would still work.
Yeah.
Okay, so it worked in the green one. -4, 8. Okay. This guy right here. Let's plug it into the red one. Y is, or I guess it doesn't matter, whichever red one I'm going to plug it into. If y is 8, plugging it in here. Is that going to be greater than or equal to what we get when you do -2 times -4 - 2? 8, is that greater than? This is -8. No, this is +8. What's +8 - 2?
6.
Is 8 greater than or equal to 6?
Yes.
It is. So this point right here is just one of infinite examples that works in the green one and the red one, both. This one will work, this one will work, this one will work, this one. Any of these. That's what the shaded areas represent. They represent points that the x and y will make the inequality true. But what about this guy? Will that work? It will work for what?
The red one.
Right, the red one.
Them.
But But it won't work for
the green one.
The green one. How about this one?
Which one?
This one right here, definitely.
Only works for the green one.
Only works for the green one.
Yeah.
Not the red one. How about this one?
Works.
Only for green because it's on the line.
Oh, I mean red. That's the red line.
Both.
It works for both. What's gonna happen when I plug it into the red one? That's gonna be equal, which is okay, because we have that equal to part. So for the red one, both sides will be equal. For the green one, it won't be equal, but this side will be bigger than this side for that point. How about this point right here? Will that work? Is that a solution to the system, to both? Yeah, for the green one, both sides will be equal. For the red one, it won't be equal, but they'll be unequal in the way that they're supposed to be,
mm-hmm.
in the way that this side is smaller than this side.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And in the end, there's no way to say, like, oh, the solution is 5, 6. There isn't a numerical answer. Right? How many numerical answers are there?
Infinity.
Infinity. There's an infinite number of ordered pairs that will solve both of these inequalities simultaneously. All in here, and on this line, and on this line. The only way to really convey what the solutions are is to show that picture. It was 14, and then we want to move on to 16.
Four-parter here. Okay,
want to spend? Here's some key words right for inequalities. We want to spend at most $21. Okay, that means we want to spend, let's write it another way, $21 or
less.
Right? We can spend less than $21 if we're going to spend at most $21. So two ways to say the same thing. Blueberries cost $4 per pound, so blueberries are $4 per pound. Strawberries cost $3 per pound. Strawberries, $3 per pound. You need at least 3 pounds to make muffins. At least 3 pounds. Okay. So fruit, right? So this is I can buy any combination, really, of blueberries and strawberries that I want, as long as they meet certain criteria, as long as I don't spend more than $21, and as long as the total pounds are at least 3 pounds, right? I can buy 4 pounds, I can buy 5 pounds. Don't get too crazy, don't buy too many pounds, because then I'll spend too much money. I'll spend over $21, okay? What they're going to ask us to do is to figure out, like, what combinations of blueberries and strawberries are okay. And they're walking this through it step by step by step. Step A, okay, is to decide what the variables are. We're familiar with X and Y as our variables. So we're going to decide what X is going to represent and what Y is going to represent.
4X for blueberries?
Not 4X. What's X represent?
Blueberries.
What about blueberries?
How much pounds?
How many pounds of blueberries? Pounds of, let's just put a B there, pounds of blueberries. Then, okay, why is it going to represent pounds of
strawberries.
All right, part A is done. Part B, right, there's walking us through it step by step, right? A system of linear inequalities represents this situation. Probably the trickiest part.
Oh,
we got two inequalities that we need. And there's two inequalities that are pretty obvious. At most, 21. At least 3.
So, 21, and then put the plus 3. Oh, I was thinking, like, one of the symbols of is greater than, or least, I mean less than.
Should it be like this?
No, the other way, less than, or equal to.
Should it be like this?
Yeah, because it should be less than or equal to.
So this is the amount that I, my budget. This is how much money I can spend. is the money that I actually do spend, should it be bigger than the amount of money that I have to spend?
No.
It needs to be smaller than the amount, or equals to the amount that I'm allowed to spend. The amount of money that I can spend, the money that I actually spend, needs to be 21 or less than 21. So, the amount that you actually spend, how do we calculate? Once we know how many pounds of blueberries and how many pounds of strawberries.
And then plug in the two numbers for x and y.
We're not plugging anything in.
Well, I mean,
for x, okay, what does x represent?
Pounds of blueberries.
Pounds of blueberries times $4 per pound. By 1 pound, $4. 2 pounds, $8. 3 pounds, $12. 4 pounds, $16. Plus 3y for the same kind of reason. Y is the pounds of strawberries. 2 pounds of strawberries times $3 per pound of strawberries is $6. Whatever other example you want to use confirms that this must be correct. Cost for blueberries, cost for strawberries needs to come in under 21 or exactly equal. And we can guess all day long, and we'll be right all day long. We'll never run out of correct like amounts of pounds of blueberries and strawberries. There's an infinite number of possibilities, especially considering you could buy like half a pound or 0.25 of a pound. We would never run out of amounts of blueberries and strawberries that we could plug in. So that's not the point. We're not just trying to plug in numbers for x and y. You might be asked to investigate an example, but that's not the point. Is to look at all the possibilities of the graph. So there's another equation, though. There's got to be another equation. Ian? Y tells me how much I'm going to spend on this. How much I spend on it needs to be less than or equal to 21, right? It shouldn't. Should the amount I spend also be greater than or equal to 3? What is it that needs to be 3 or less? Or 3, sorry, 3 or more, yeah?
X and Y.
So the combination
pounds
of X and Y, the number of pounds, right? Just straight X plus Y, pounds plus pounds, needs to come out to be greater than 3 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
So we have two inequalities, which we can then graph, which I'll graph quickly, save us some time. I'm gonna rewrite this in slope-intercept form. It's gonna look like y is less than or equal to negative 4/3 x plus 7. The other one's going to be y is greater than or equal to negative x plus 3. Rewriting it in slope-intercept form. Nearly there, because it's going to ask us to graph it in part C. Down a bit. Well, I guess we want to mostly concentrate on the first quadrant. All right, so we have a y-intercept 7. Slope of negative 4/3. That means you're going to go to the right 3 and down 4.
Wait, does it matter which way you go? Over 4, down 3?
Well, that would give you two different lines, so it's gotta be important, right?
So the bottom one's the one that goes over.
That's right. It is okay if it comes out to be exactly equal, so we'll use a solid line.
No, you go left one and down one.
Not left one and down one, either a right one and down one or left one and up one.
Oh.
It's got to have a negative slope, right? Negative down and to the right. So as a y-intercept of 3, slope of negative 1, you could write negative 1 over 1 if you like. Now you can see 1 to the right and 1 down. We're going to use a solid line again because it's okay if they're equal.
So they'll end up running into each other?
They would, but we'll talk about that. They would actually wind up running into each other somewhere down in the fourth quadrant, right? Where x is positive and y is negative. So if I wanted to find the intersection of the lines, that it would be where X is positive, X represents blueberries, and Y represents strawberries. I'd have to buy a bunch of blueberries and somehow buy negative strawberries. So, where with equations, we cared more about where the lines intersected. Here we're worried about where do the shaded intersections lie. All right, so for this red one, where do we shade?
Down.
For the black one, where do we shade?
Up.
Above.
Okay, it's not Christmas this time, but it's Deadpool, I guess. Right here, red and black. The intersection of the two, really, this area in particular, for realistic values of blueberries and strawberries, both being positive. Right in here. There they are. All the infinite possibilities of the numbers of pounds of blueberries I can buy and strawberries that I can buy. Anything that's in here, there. It's a combination of blueberries and strawberries. That, two things, cost less than or equal to $21 and is at least 3 pounds worth. 3 pounds. There's a limit on, it sounds like you could just go crazy on the pounds, but if you buy too many pounds, it's too much money, right? That's why there's only a certain area. Is it possible to buy 4 pounds of blueberries and 1 pound of strawberries in this situation? Well, let's look at the graph. 1, 2, 3, 4, and... Hey, calm down. 1.
Yeah.
Ooh, that looks like it's...
It is possible.
Is it right on the line?
Yes, and if it is, that means yes.
Yes, solid line means points on the line are cool.
Yep.
It's in both shaded areas. It's in the shaded area of the black. It's on the red line. Right? Did I get that right?
Mm-hmm.
The shaded area of the black is on the red line, so yeah, it works. So we'll have exactly, what is the black one? So that represents the pound. So you'll have exactly, oh, that's not right. Oh, it's right on the red line. So you'll spend exactly $21, and you'll have, what, 5 pounds worth of berries. All right, so